Hello students, how are you? I know you all are waiting for my new video. Today I am going to explain a new topic related with the chapter motion, and the topic is graphical representation of motion. Right? What graphical representation of motion, what it means? It means we want to represent the different variables related with motion in terms of graph. And what are the different variables? In the case of motion, the variables are distance, speed, and time. Okay, now there are three important variables: distance, speed, and time. As we know, we all know, if I change my position, then that position change with respect to time. It means that when an object change its position with respect to time, the representation is called distance time graph. Distance time graph. So one method is we draw the graph in between distance and time, and that graph is called as distance time graph. And the second is, when the distance change, when the position change with respect to time, then we all know that speed is equal to distance upon time, so the speed also change. So in the second case, we make another graph between speed and time, and that graph is known as speed time graph or velocity time graph. So here we all discuss the two topics by the help of graph. One is the distance time graph and second one is the velocity time graph. Now I am going to take the first case, that is the distance time graph. Now, the first representation, that is distance time graph. Here, we want to make a graph between two variables, two quantities. One is distance and second is time. Right? Now, we have to decide, when we want to draw any graph, the graph have two axes. One axis is called x-axis and second axis is called y-axis. Now we want to decide in which axis we put the different variable. Always remember, the time is put on the x-axis and distance always consider on the y-axis. The question arises, why? Because when the time change, object position will also change. When the time change, so object position also change. It means the distance depend upon time, and the variable which depend upon other variable is always show along the y-axis, and independent variable is always show along the x-axis. So when we make a graph between distance time, we always represent the time along the x-axis and represent the distance along the y-axis. Okay? Now, it is clear that in which axis we put the variable, the distance and time. It is clear, the distance always put along the x-axis and time, distance always put along the y-axis and time always put along the x-axis. Okay? Now, there are different cases. Now, in this case, there are also a different cases. The case is, when I am saying, the speed is constant, the object is moving with constant speed. It means the distance is changes with time, but speed cannot be changed. In that situation, how we make the graph? We are taking here the first graph, when the object move with uniform speed. The first is distance time graph of an object. Here I am writing case 1, distance time graph when distance time graph of an object moving with uniform speed, So here I am going to take the first case, the distance time graph between distance and time and condition when uniform speed, the speed is constant. Now how we make, I am going to take one table here, right? Time, distance and speed, okay? Now if I am saying the time is 0, the distance covered by the object is 0, so what about the speed? That is 0. I am saying the time is 1, speed is 2, distance is 2, so what about the speed? That is 2. I am saying the time become 2, now the distance become 4, speed is again 2. Now I am saying time become 3, distance becomes 6, speed is again 2. So along by the help of this table, it is clear that with respect to time, distance will change, but the speed is constant. Speed is uniform, and that is the case when distance time graph you want to make of an object with the uniform speed. Now how we make this graph? The graph is looking, what is the what the condition for that graph, how graph looks. Now I am going to make a graph here. The graph between distance and time, time along x-axis, distance along y-axis. What is the unit of distance? Meter. What is the unit of time? Second. And what is the unit of speed? Yes, meter per second. Distance is in meter, time is in second. Okay. Now, if I am going to make a sections here, scale here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, make the graph. When the time is 0, the distance covered by object is 0. When the time 1, the distance covered by the object 1. When the time 2, the distance covered by the object 2. When the time 3, the distance covered by the object 3. When the time become 4, the distance covered by the object 4. Like this. Now if you make a graph, the graph is straight line. The graph is straight line. So this is the first case, the distance time graph for the condition of uniform or constant speed. Now I am going to a second case. Now one thing more, look here. If I am taking a point here, the point A, right? And I am going to take a second point here, the point B. Okay. Now make a perpendicular along the x-axis like this. Similarly, the perpendicular along the y-axis like this. Right. Now, by the help of distance time graph, what quantity we have to find? If we know the distance time graph, we always find the speed. Remember that point. If we have a distance time graph, by the help of distance time graph, we always find the speed. How? Look here. If I am saying, here the time will be t1, here the time will be t2, at t1 time the distance is s1, the distance is s2 at the time t2. Now how we can find the speed? As we all know that speed is equal to distance upon time. Now by the help of this graph, the distance, change in distance, what is the change in distance? That is s2 minus s1. And what about the time? T2 minus T1. What it gives? It gives us a speed. So by the help of graph, distance time graph, we always find the speed. If in a question you have a distance time graph, you always find the speed by the help of that graph. So I am going to give a note here. By help of distance time graph, we have to find what factor? That is speed. Okay? Now, the case 2. Now, I am going to take a case 2. What about the case 2? Again, we want to make a distance time graph of an object, but here the speed is non-uniform. It means speed is variable, speed is changing. When we make a graph between distance and time, the condition is given here. The speed is non-uniform. So first of all, we want to make a graph between distance and time, and we all know that the time is shown along the x-axis, distance shown along the y-axis. Distance always in meter and time always in second. Okay? Now, before design the graph, before plot the graph, I am going to take one table here by which I explain you the condition. Again, I am going to make the table between time, distance and speed. Okay? Now, if I am saying time is 0, the distance covered by an object is 0. So, what about speed? 0. I am taking the time 1, distance 3 meter. What about the speed? That is 3. I am taking the time 2. Distance covered by an object is now 8. What about the speed? That is 4. Now I am taking the distance 3, time 3. Distance is 9. What about the speed? Again 3. So here you look, the speed is not a constant. Speed is changing. So this is called the distance time graph for a non-uniform speed. As we all know that, what is the non-uniform motion? The motion, the position will be changed unequal with respect to the equal time interval. That is non-uniform motion. So in the case of non-uniform motion, the speed becomes non-uniform, and we want to make a graph for the non-uniform condition. Whenever you want to make a graph for the non-uniform condition, now scaling here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 1, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You make this graph on your graph paper. Okay? So, when you make the graph on your graph paper, it make correct. Okay? I am just explaining here. Now, when the distance is 0, time is 0, distance 0. When the time becomes 1, the distance becomes 3. Now, here, like this. When the time becomes 2, the distance becomes 4. In the case of distance, 4, here. Right? When the condition is time becomes 3, the distance becomes 9. Time becomes 3, the distance becomes 9, here. So here the graph is looking like this, something like this. Okay, the graph is something like this, S, like that. So this graph is not a linear graph. This graph is not a linear graph, something curved. Okay, so in the case of non-uniform motion, the graph is coming as curved graph, right, like this. So when the motion is non-uniform, your graph is something curved. Okay, so there are two cases in the distance time graph. One case is the distance time graph for the uniform speed, and second is distance time graph for the non-uniform speed. Hope you understand this topic. Now I am going to velocity time graph. Now the case 2, I am going to explain how you can make the velocity time graph. It means Now we have to make a graph between two variables. One is the velocity and second is the time. Now, if we make a graph, there are two axes again. Always remember, time is show on the x-axis and velocity always represent along the y-axis. So whenever you make the graph, velocity time graph, always put the velocity on the y-axis and always put the time along the x-axis. Okay. Now here I am taking a case one, the velocity time graph for a uniform motion. Velocity time graph for a uniform motion. What about the uniform motion? Uniform motion says your velocity or your speed cannot be changed with time. Your velocity or speed cannot be changed with time, then the motion is called as uniform motion. So in the case of uniform motion, if I'm saying you are driving your bike, right? In that condition, your bike is moving with a constant speed 40 km/h, right? Which means the speed is constant, that is 40 km/h. Even the time is changing, but your speed is constant 40 km/h. So the condition is there, the velocity time graph for the uniform motion. So if I'm saying the speed is constant, so let a car or bike moving with constant speed I'm saying 40 m/s, right? Now how we make the graph in that condition? We want to make the graph for that condition and we want to make the graph between velocity and time. So we put the time along the x-axis and velocity along the y-axis. Velocity unit always in meter per second, time unit always in second. If I'm saying there is a scale 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on for the time, here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and so on. So by this condition, when the motion is uniform, your bike is moving with the speed of 40 m/s along a straight line, right? So in that condition, time changes but the value of speed cannot be changed. So you make a graph like this. And what that graph represent? The graph represent a parallel line along the x-axis. So when the motion is uniform, the velocity time graph is always parallel along the x-axis. The velocity time graph parallel along the x-axis. So for this graph, time changes but the speed or velocity is constant. Speed and velocity is constant and that is a constant line parallel to the x-axis. So whenever you make a graph for the uniform motion, velocity time graph, that graph represents a straight line parallel to the x-axis. Clear? Now I'm going to take the case 2. We want to make a velocity time graph again, but the condition is motion is uniformly accelerated. It means in that motion, acceleration cannot be changed. Acceleration is constant for the velocity time graph. As we all know that acceleration formula, velocity upon time. So whenever we have a velocity and time, we find the acceleration value. But here the condition is acceleration constant. So I'm going to make a table here between the time, velocity and acceleration. Okay, if I am saying the time is 0, velocity is 0, so the value of acceleration will be 0. If I am saying time is 1, velocity is 20 m/s, what about the acceleration? 20. I am saying time is 2, velocity is 40 m/s, what about the acceleration? 20. I am saying time is 3, velocity is 60 m/s, what about the acceleration? 20. I am saying time is 4, velocity is 80, what about the acceleration? 20. So velocity is meter per second and acceleration meter per second square, time is in second. So here look, the acceleration is constant when even the velocity changes. So when velocity change, acceleration constant, that acceleration is called as uniform acceleration. So whenever we make a graph between time and velocity for uniformly accelerated motion, the graph is looking like this. The graph is looking like this. The graph is again a straight line like this. Okay, so graph is a straight line like this whenever the motion is uniform. Okay, the graph is looking like this. If I'm saying this is a point 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 20, 40, 60, 80. Right? So for the case of 80, there will be 4 and so on. Right? So this is a graph. Always remember, when there is a uniform acceleration, the graph is straight line. And whenever the graph is straight line, if I am saying that here I am taking a two points, a point A and point B. Right? At the point A, the time is, let assume, as t1. At the point B, the time is assumed as t2. At that condition, I am assuming the velocity or speed as v1. In that condition, I am assuming the velocity and speed as v2. Okay, so I am taking a two points on that graph, and I assume the time as t1 and t2, as well as at the time t1, the velocity assumed as v1. At the time t2, the velocity I am assuming as v2. Now, what we find by the help of speed time or velocity time graph? Remember, as I told you earlier, whenever a distance time graph, we have to find the speed or velocity. So whenever the graph is in velocity and time, we have to always find the distance. How? We have to find the distance. If I am saying this is a point C and this become a point D. So here, look here, the dark portion. Here a trapezium made. Here the graph make a trapezium. If I am making a straight line here, this trapezium divided into two parts. One is the rectangle and second is the triangle. So whenever you have to find the distance by the help of velocity time graph, you have to find the area of the shaded portion. If I am saying this is the shaded portion, okay, so you have, if you find the area of that shaded portion, easily you can find the area, and the value of area is nothing but the distance, right? The value of area is nothing but the distance. So if you find the area, I am writing here, whenever velocity time graph is given, you have to find distance by the help of that graph. Right? And how you find the distance? To find the distance, find the area of shaded portion. When you find the area of shaded portion, easily you find the distance. Okay. Now, if you find the distance, now what you write here? Here the distance is, you can write the distance as S, and S is equal to area of A, B, C, D, A. A, B, C, D. Area of A, B, C, D, A. Okay. Now this A, total area is divided in two parts. Area of this triangle plus area of rectangle. So we divide it in two parts. Area of rectangle. Rectangle value is A, E, C, D. Plus area of triangle. Triangle is ABE. So when you find the area of rectangle plus area of triangle, easily you find the area of this whole portion, and that is nothing but the distance covered by an object. That is nothing but the distance covered by an object. Hope you understand. Now you all know that area of rectangle is base into length into breadth. Area of triangle half base into height, half base into height, half length into breadth. So if you want to express this, you can express as S is equal to, for area of rectangle we can write AE into EC plus area of triangle as half AE into BE. Okay, now if we put the values in a graph with the value given as, you put the value and find the total distance covered by an object. So remember the point, this method is only applicable when the motion is uniformly accelerated. So when the motion is uniformly accelerated and question says find the area, find the distance by the help of graph, you can do find the area of that portion. Easily you find the distance by the help of graph. Okay. Now students, I am going to take a very important topic, that is kinematic equation by graphical method. Right? In my earlier video, you watch the kinematic equation by analytical method. Here I am going to solve again the kinematic equation by the graphical method. Do you remember that there are three equations of motion or kinematic equation? V is equal to u plus at, S is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square is equal to u square plus 2s. Now we have derived these two equations by the help of graph, and here I am going to take a graph between velocity and time. Let us assume there is an object at the time t equal to 0. The object have a velocity u. Remember, at the time t equal to 0, object have some velocity, and that velocity is represented by u. And after the time t, now object changes position. After the time t, the object velocity become v. Again I repeat, at the time t equal to 0, we assume that object have a velocity u, and after time t, the object gain its new velocity, that is v. And here the assume as motion or acceleration is uniform. I am assuming the acceleration is uniform. Now if we want to make the graph between velocity and time, graph between velocity and time is looking like this. When the time is 0, when the time is 0, when the time is 0, how much velocity of an object? Let u. Okay. And after time t, if this time become t, after time t, now the velocity of an object become v. Okay. Now if we make a graph, that graph start from u up to v like this. Right? This graph not start from 0, because at that time 0 the object have some speed, some velocity. So graph start from u and end at the time t, that is v. Now I am putting a perpendicular here like this. Okay, I am going to make a perpendicular like this, as well as I make a straight line here also. Right? Now this is a time t. If let us assume this point as A, this point as B, this point as D, and if I make a straight line here, I am assuming this point as C. Now we have a three equation. If we want to find the first equation, if we want to find the first equation by the help of this graph, the first equation V is equal to u plus at. We want to derive this equation by the help of this graph. Now if the velocity change, then there is an acceleration. And what is the formula for acceleration? By the formula of acceleration, we can write A is equal to change in velocity upon change in time. Right? What about the change in velocity? the final velocity is v minus initial velocity u at the final velocity time is t, at the initial velocity the time is 0, and this is equal to v minus u upon t. This is v minus u upon t. Now if we cross multiply, we can write as at is equal to v minus u, or we can write v is equal to u plus at. So by the help of graph, right? Here, how you can write the v and u value, right? I am writing here. How you can write this v and u value by the help of graph? You can write a is equal to v. How much the v value? That is bd. Minus, what is the value of u? OA. Upon what is the value of t? That is OD. Okay. Now if we put the value of bd, bd is how much? That is v. How much the value of OA? That is u. And how much the value of OD? That is t. So answer is v minus u upon t, and your relation comes v is equal to u plus at. This is the solution for first equation. Now please note down, I'm going to rub it. Now the second equation by the help of graph, equation 2. What is the second equation? S is equal to ut plus half at square. Right? We want to derive this equation. And I told you, whenever you want to find the distance by the help of velocity time graph, you have to find the area. So, if we want to find the value of S here, we find the area of trapezium. What is the trapezium? OABD. OABD. Right? If we put the formula of trapezium, the formula of trapezium says 1 upon 2 half sum of parallel heights, that is BD plus OA, multiplied by distance, that is OD. I put the formula of trapezium here, half sum of parallel heights multiplied by distance. Now put the numerical values. Half. What is the value of BD? That is B. What is the value of OA? That is U. What is the value of OD? That is T. Okay. Now, by help of equation V is equal to U plus AT. Why we put this equation here? Because in this equation there is no term of V. In this equation there is no term of V. So we replace this V by the help of V equal to U plus AT. Now I am writing with the help of this equation, I am going to write this equation as, put the value of V as U plus AT plus U into T. Now what happened? 1 upon 2, 2U plus AT into T. Now what happened? If we write as 1 upon 2 into 2UT plus 1 upon 2 into AT square. So 2 is cancelled out. What answer is given? Answer comes S is equal to UT plus half AT square. This is the derivation of second equation by this graph. Now I am going to solve, please note down. Now I am going to solve third equation, that is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. We want to solve the third equation by the graph. V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Again the same approach, because here the V and U are present and as well as distance is here. So we take the same approach. By the distance is find by the area of trapezium OABD. Right? Write the formula of trapezium. Half BD plus OA multiplied by OD. BD plus OA multiplied by OD. Put the values. Half V plus U multiplied by T. Which quantity you want to eliminate from this formula? Yes, you want to eliminate the time because in this answer time is absent. So we want to eliminate the time here from here. So as we know that, what about the acceleration? A is equal to v minus u upon t. So from this formula, we write t is equal to v minus u upon a. We write t is equal to v minus u upon a. So put this value in the equation 1. Put t is equal to v minus u upon a in equation 1. Now you get s is equal to half v plus u v minus u upon a. And finally we get 2as is equal to v square minus u square, because this is v plus u, v minus u, v square minus u square, and 2a is cross multiplied here. 2as equal to v square minus u square. After arranging this equation, we find that v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Now, we find all three equations of motion by the help of graph. So you have now two methods to solve the equation of motion. One is the analytical method, as I explained earlier, and one is the graphical method, as I explained by the help of this video. Now students, the last topic from the chapter motion is circular motion. What do you mean by circular motion? When an object moves in circular path with the constant speed, the motion is called as circular motion. When an object moves in a circular path but its speed is constant, then the motion is called as circular motion. So what about the circular motion? When an object moves in circular path with constant speed, the motion is called circular motion. When an object moves in a circular path with the constant speed, the motion is called circular motion. Now I am going to explain this by the help of a figure. If I am making a figure, a circular path like this, right? And an object A. If I am saying this is an object A, this object moves in a circular path with the constant speed v. Now, if this object moves in this circular path with the constant speed v, the motion is called circular motion. Now I am going to assume the radius of this circular motion as r, and the time period to complete this path by the particle or by the object is t. What I take as assumption? I take, let the radius of circular path is r, and time period to complete the circular path is capital T. So here I am assuming the radius of the circular path is r, and time period to complete this circular path is t. And if we want to find this value of speed, so we all know that speed is nothing but that is distance upon time. Speed is distance upon time. And what is the distance covered by this particle in that circular path? That is nothing but the circumference of that circle. Right? The circumference of that circle is the distance covered by an object on this circular path. So we write the distance as circumference of circle upon time. and we all know that the formula of circumference is yes 2 pi r upon what is the time, that is t. So this is the formula to find the speed of an object when that object is moving in a circular path. When the object is moving in a circular path, you have to find the speed of that object. You can find by the help of this formula, v is equal to 2 pi r upon t. Now, in my next video, I am going to solve some NCERT problems, examples. Now, concept of the motions are completed here. Revise that, and if you have any problem, write in a comment box of this video. And as well as if these videos are useful for you, all of you, please subscribe our channel Physics Clinic. Thank you so much.